Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to fit your text anywhere in your document. Now, that might be fitting your text on a lower amount of pages, from say 3 pages to 2 pages, or you might just want a little bit of text in your document somewhere placed, or several pieces of text. So the first thing I'm going to do is to show you how to get all of this text onto just these 2 pages, and there's a variety of different ways to do that. So the first way, if we just select everything, just press Command or Control and A to select all of your text. And then the first quick and easy way is simply to go up to your font size and reduce the font size. So if you go down to 10, we're currently at 12. If we go down to 10, you can see that's reduced it to 2 pages. We could probably do it to 10.5. And we've got that text down to 2 pages. Now, what you might see is there's a large gap at the bottom, which you might think, well, actually, some of this text up here can go down to the bottom. So click up here and then just press the delete key to take it down to the bottom. Now, you can see it's a new paragraph, but if I go to this section here, to the end of this paragraph, and press the return key, you can see how it bounces back. So what you need to do is do the same, press the delete key, but then go to the end of this next line here. So it's the end of the first line of that new paragraph. Just press the return key. Nothing will happen. You just say there's a little tiny bump, and then go back to the paragraph before and then just press the return key. And as you can see now, then that first line goes onto this page. Now you can do that again. Go to the second line of that paragraph and do the same. Just press the return key. And do the same with the following line, press the return key. So you've gone to each of the ends of the lines of those paragraphs. And then do that again, press the return key there, and you can see that Word will then fit as much as it possibly can onto the bottom of this page. Now, if you don't want to do that, you can adjust the font. So let's select it all again and go back to 12 and go back to where we were. So this time, if we go to the fonts, you can sometimes choose a slightly different font, which will again move all the text across. So you can choose DIN, which is a font which is very close, the letters are very close to each other. You can choose DIN, and you can see here that it has reduced, but again, we've got the same issue here. So again, if we were to take that down to the bottom, let's just hit the return key at the ends of those 3 lines, then press the return key again. So I just press the delete key, return key again. You can see I've now reduced it down. There's a big gap there and a big gap there. And there's obviously some return key somewhere. There we go. If I go to the Home tab and I click on this icon here, Show and Hide Formatting, you can see all the return keys. So if I just go back a couple of steps, you can see I've just pressed the return key here at the bottom. And I've got 2 return keys here, so delete one, so you've only got 1 space between each line. But you can see I've got lots of return keys here, which is why it's gone over to this 3rd page. So I just need to delete them, and then it will reduce that page down to 2 pages. So that's the second way to do it. So the 3rd way, again, if I select everything, let's take that back to the original. There we go. What I can do is I can play with my margins. Now, you've got rulers at the side of your page. If you can't see rulers, go to View and make sure rulers are checked at the top here. And then if you hover your cursor between the white section and grey section, it will change into a double-headed arrow. If you click and just drag up, it will reduce that margin at the top. You can do the same at the bottom, just pull that down. But also you can do the sides as well. So if you go to the top here, we can do exactly the same. We can pull that over to the left and then again to the right. And you can fill your page. And again, you can put as much text as you possibly can on those pages and reduce it down to those 2 pages only. So that's the 3rd way you can do it. So if we just go back a few steps and go back to the original layout, what if you want to just insert some text inside? I'm just going to get rid of these formatting marks. Inside the text anywhere here. So let's say you wanted to put some text anywhere in this document. Let's go to Insert and Draw a Text Box. Click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Click and drag out a text box. And let's just grab some text from here. I'm just going to copy and paste this text into this text box. When you go into a text box, you must click twice to get your cursor in your text box. And then I'm just going to paste that text in. And now with this text box, we can move it anywhere we like this. We can resize it and the text will fit to this text box however we move this cursor around. We can also extend it like this. And if you do this, you have to extend the bottom to fit all the words in. So you get the idea. Now, if I click away from this text box, you can see it comes with a border. And if I move it, you can see it also comes with a white background. Now, you don't have to have those two. If you want to get rid of them, select it, go to Shape Format, and just use Shape Outline. Click on the drop down and select No Outline, Shape Fill, and select No Fill. And then you can see it's completely transparent. And if I click away, there's no border. So let's say we wanted to, let's just change the font of this text. Go to the Home tab and let's just choose this font here and then just make that a little bit bigger. There we go. So let's just say we wanted to fit that text. I'm going to put it into the middle. So let's center that text with that icon there. So let's just say we wanted to pop this text over in the middle here. Now you can see I can place it here and that doesn't work particularly well. So what we need to do is change the wrapping of this text box. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Wrap Text and select top and bottom. As you can see now, once again, we can move this text box anywhere we want to. And as we move the text box, the original text of the document will move around it. You can center this box using the alignment tool, select it, Shape Format, Align, Align to Center, and your text will be perfectly lined up in the middle of your document. Again, don't be afraid to move it around. If you wanted to put it at the edge here, let's say, for example, you had a picture and you wanted to move it around here, you can do that as well. You can also move it onto a different page. If you want to move that to another page, you can do that too. Let's say you wanted to be a little bit more artistic and you wanted a header. Let's say you wanted this text here and you wanted a big title above this text box. What we're going to do is copy and paste this text box for the heading. So I'm going to press Command and Control C, deselect it, Command and Control V, and we've got another text box here. So our original text box is down here. So let's just select all of this text in here because we can't see it very well. Let's put it in bold. There we go. And then we've got this text box here. So let's just say we wanted to have a title. Reading is easier. So let's select that text. I'm going to put it all into uppercase. So select this icon here, uppercase, bold, and let's just change that to another font. And let's just increase the size of it. Let's say it's to 22. Okay. So now we want this text to go above this text here. We can just move it above like this. And then let's say we want this to be extended across. And we didn't want it to be in the center. Let's align it to the left. And we want it all to line up with the original text. We can just move that over with our arrow key. If it jumps too much, hit your control key and the command key, and then just move your arrow key left and right. And then you can line that up with the side as well. Let's just say you want some text and all of your paragraphs to move around it. All you need to do, let's just click and drag out a new text box. So select the text box, hold down your Alt key, click and drag out a new text box. And then we're going to make this like a column. Let's move it over to this page here. Let's just move that over. Let's say we want this flow of text to come around here. All you need to do is go to Shape Format, Wrap Text, and select Tight. And now all of the text will move around that box. Now, sometimes you might feel that the margin between the text box and the actual text here is a bit too close. So select the text box, right click, go to Wrap Text and go down to More Layout Options. And you can see here distance from text. We've currently got top and bottom is 0, left and right is 0.32. So let's take that up to 1 centimeter each. and click OK. And now you can see the distance from the text box text and the document text has now increased. And it looks a little neater as we move around the document. If you want to fit text at the very bottom of your page, but you don't want to use the headers and footers because obviously they duplicate on every page, all you need to do, let's select this box here. I'm going to hold down my Alt key to copy it. All you need to do is literally drag this text box down to the bottom of your, right, let's change the wrapping of this, select it, shape format, so I can't move it to the bottom of the page. I go to in front of text, and then you can move it anywhere around your documents. If you want it right down at the bottom here, and you just wanted to put a little bit of information, let's say page 101, it won't appear in the headers and footers, so it won't be duplicated on every page, but you just wanted to put it on one particular page, then you can do that too. Same with the headers, just duplicate this information, and you can simply put this anywhere in your document. Obviously, if you want to print it out, you do have to be mindful of how close to the edges your printer can print. But obviously, if you're just simply going to send it or save it as a PDF, then it's absolutely fine. Additionally, if you want text to run down the side, and let's say you want to put some writing in the margins, there we go, let's just reduce the size of that text. Let's select it, or Command and Control A, go to the Home tab, let's reduce it down to 10. Let's choose a different normal text there. And you just wanted to put a little bit of writing here. Doesn't matter where it is really, you can put it anywhere you like. You need to put it in the margins, that's absolutely fine. You can write a whole different column there. It's absolutely fine. Then if you needed to change the color of this text because it needed to highlight something, just use this font color tool here in the Home tab. And then you can just use that to indicate some information or write something about a particular paragraph. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.